as we're at a global women's summit. Do you see a difference between men millennials and women millennials? I mean, you work and interact, and are there differences, or is it pretty similar? Anybody have a perspective on that?
Being around the G20 conversation around women's workforce participation for about 6 years now, it never ceases to amaze me that we're still almost solely focused on women as employees, and we're still not talking about women as employers and women as, you know, self-employed economic agents. I think there's a whole conversation around what we need to do to empower female entrepreneurs that we're still not having to the degree that we need to, how we break down those barriers, how we create more opportunities and pathways in that regard. We've only got about 12.8% of our girls studying advanced level maths in Australia right now in year 12. We've got a long way to go in terms of closing this skills gap, and we don't have the time to be dilly-dallying around about it. This is a really mission-critical piece around not only how we change this in schools, but how we provide reskilling opportunities for women mid-career, because these transition points are going to be really, really necessary. So I think that they're significant, just some of the generational things that I acknowledge that are probably different in our generation that I think we need to be having more of a conversation around.
Interestingly, I'm not sure that millennials see each other that differently. You know, my millennial husband would never think that there wasn't something that I couldn't do, and vice versa. I think the same of him. I feel that everyone should have the same opportunity, irrespective of when they just happen to be born. At the same time, I know that there's tokenism, and that's another thing that gets thrown around a lot. And when I see women performing leadership roles or entering into leadership roles, I want it to be because they actually deserve to be there, and not because there was a quota or a percent that we're trying to, you know, that we're trying to aim for.
Elise, I don't know you all that well, but I've had the privilege of getting to know you. I watched you accept one of the Telstra Business Women Awards last year, an amazing recognition of the contribution you've made in business. Yeah, round of applause for that. It was great. In my mind, you would never, ever, ever be capable of being token. And if it was a quota that got you in the door, that gave you an opportunity to be at a table, I don't believe for a second there's a problem with that. I think that's fantastic that we had something in place that allowed you to be at the table, because never would your contribution be token.
That's a really good point, actually. Yeah.
I want to go to a topic I'm passionate about. We've talked a lot about purpose, but I believe in well-being. And well-being is critical if we're all going to live 100 years, right? We got to take care of ourselves. So, and this, I think, is incredibly important also to the millennials. So, Elise, what are your thoughts on that?
This is something that's really close to my heart, because well-being isn't just, you know, being able to physically move around. It isn't just being able to get to work. It's so much bigger than that. It's about your headspace when you're at work. It's about your headspace when you're at home. And it's about your ability to live a fruitful life in whatever that means to you. It means that we need to find things that make us tick, that make us feel alive, and that will be different to each particular person. But we also need to make time, and whether that's time that your organisation gives you or time that you make for yourself, where you can constantly replenish and make yourself healthier and go for a walk, or, you know, watch a trashy soap opera or whatever you need to do to reset, and just keep resetting, because if you just keep running the race, you're not going to get to 100.
Please give this incredible panel a big hand.